Well, I have proven them false. I've shown that that God is not the author of the Quran. It flunks its own test.
All right, we'll begin with you, Mr. Ataie. Can you give a brief account of the story of Jesus' rescue? What were the events of that day? Where can this account be found in the Quran and or historical documents? You have 2 minutes.
The Quran does not go into specifics as to exactly what happened, you see. The Quran says he was saved, that he wasn't killed, he wasn't crucified, and based on the reliability of the text of the Quran and also on the life example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who is the most universal messenger, he's the most historical messenger, you see, we take these statements as true until they are proven false. Now, what exactly happened to him? There are theories. Muslims have devised, like I was saying, the substitution theory, and these aren't some things that we invented by ourselves, you see. These have some background in Gnostic Gospels. As he says, they're Gnostic Gospels, they're heretical Gospels and whatnot. And these things were found just recently. You know, prior to 1945, when they found the Nag Hammadi Gospel, it was common knowledge that only the Christology of the Quran says Jesus wasn't crucified. But now we know, based on recent discoveries, like the second treatise of the Great Seth, you know, where's the first treatise of the Great Seth? Maybe they'll find that in another 20 years. That'll be very, very close to the time of Jesus, and they'll say, no, he wasn't crucified. You see, these things, the Christian beliefs are evolving over time. When these things start to come out over time, these discoveries, it only proves the Quran more and only disproves the Quran, the Bible more as well at the same time.
Well, in terms of what actually happened there, he's right, the Quran doesn't give any details. But as I mentioned, when you talk about Simon of Cyrene and the sign of Jonah, they contradict each other. And what I'm saying here is his views of what happened contradict one another. And he said that they believe these statements until true until proven false. Well, I have proven them false. I've shown that God is not the author of the Quran. It flunks its own test. Again, he mentions the Nag Hammadi library and that we didn't know about any of these gospels before then. Well, sure we did. The early church fathers speak of most of these gospels. It mentions the gospel of Judas, the gospel of Thomas, gospel of the Hebrews. All of these had been mentioned long before. I mean, over 1,000 years before the Nag Hammadi manuscripts. It's just now we could read these gospels in their entirety.